Students, initially we learnt different types of quadrilaterals and properties. Today, in part 4 from chapter 3, we are going to learn construction of quadrilaterals. Construction need some information, then only a perfect quadrilateral can be constructed. 5 independent measurements are required to construct a quadrilateral. To construct a quadrilateral, information provided in 5 different forms. So, we would draw quadrilateral when the following measurements are given. See the first one. When 4 sides and 1 angle are given, this I written in the short form. First side I used S, for angle I used A. So, S, A. Second one, when 4 sides and 1 diagonal are given, this D meant for diagonal, S, D. When 3 sides and 2 diagonals are given, S, D. When 2 adjacent sides and 3 angles are given, S, A. This angle is included by the 2 sides. And the last case, when 3 sides and 2 included angles are given. This angle is included by these two sides. This angle is included by these two sides. So, S. Now, let us learn each case with examples. See the first construction. Construct the quadrilateral ABCD with AB 5.5 cm. BC 3.5 cm, CD 4 cm, AD 5 cm and angle A 45 degrees. Now here, let us see with these measurements how a quadrilateral can be constructed when they are given 4 sides and 1 angle. Children, before constructing a quadrilateral, we have to follow some rules strictly. What are those rules means? Always you have to use white sheet for construction. And we require some geometrical instruments like ruler, protractor, compass. All these things you have to keep ready with you. And you have to study the given data carefully. And also you have to use dark pencil with sharp end. And first you have to draw rough sketch, then we go for main construction. And also you don't overwrite and don't thicken the lines and points while doing the construction. So all these things you have to follow carefully before doing the construction of quadrilateral with the given data. Now you see the data. What they given here? AB 5.5 cm, BC 3.5 cm, CD 4 cm, AD 5 cm and angle A 45 degrees. Now here, first we draw rough sketch. So before drawing the rough sketch, we have to take the base which includes the angle. It is most important rule. Here they given angle A as 45 degrees. So we have to take the base which includes this A. So we have AB 5 cm and also we have AD 5 cm. So out of these two, anyone you can take it as base. Now here children, rough sketch, no need of exact, just only for idea we are drawing. First let us take AB as base. Which measures 5.5 cm. Next, what we have to do? They given angle A 45 degrees. So, using compass, we will construct this 45 degrees at A as center. Let us name this ray as X. So, here XAB gives measures 45 degrees. Next, what we have to do? Again, we have to construct AD 5 cm. So, take A as center with radius 5 cm. You draw an arc which cuts AX ray at D. This is only for idea children. This is not exact. Again, we have to construct CD and BC. So, with D as center, 4 centimeters radius, draw an arc. Now, we have to construct BC 3.5 centimeters. So, with B as center, with 3.5 centimeters radius, you cut this arc. These two arcs intersect at C. So, we have to join CD and BC. This is your rough figure. Now, let us start main construction. Children, you have to fix your pencil in the compass. Just for for drawing the dark figure, I fix it here, small sketch pen. But you have to fix a sharp pencil in it. Tight it. Take the ruler. First, what we have to construct? AB base. So, what you have to do here to construct AB line segment 5.5 centimeters, first you have to mark starting point at 0, and as it is 5.5, 5 after 5th line. So this is your end point. First mark starting point and end point, then join this. Immediately you name children A, B, which is 5.5 centimeters. Now what we have to do, we have to construct angle A 45 degrees using compass. Now take the compass, take some convenient radius, place your needle end at A. Just hold your compass on the top, children, don't hold the pencil. Just take some convenient radius, place your needle end at A. With some convenient radius, you draw an arc. After that, don't disturb the radius. Where this arc intersects on AB line segment, from that point, you draw another arc. This is your 60 degrees. Now, where this arc intersects, from this point, you draw another arc. This is another 60. So from here to here it is 60. This is another 60. So from here to here it is 120. Now here, to get 90 degrees, this second 60 we have to bisect. So from this point you draw one arc. Again from this point you draw another arc. Where these two arcs intersect, if you join from A, this is your 90 degrees, children. If you bisect 90 degrees, then we get 45 degrees. So from this point and from this point, you have to take centers and draw two arcs. From here to here, one arc. This is another arc. Now join. If they did not intersect, you can extend. You name here X. Now the here XAB measures 45 degrees. If you want, you can check using protractor. You know how to place the protractor? At this vertex, you keep the midpoint of the protractor and place the line segment. This baseline should coincide with this line segment. Now you see here, exactly it is 45 degrees. Next thing we have to do, we have to construct AD 5 centimeters. So you have to take 5 centimeters radius. So your starting point is here, ending point is at 5 centimeters. So with this radius, with this 5 centimeters radius, Place your needle end at A. Draw an arc which intersects this AX ray at D. What is the length of AD here? 5 centimeters. Next, what we have to do? With D as center, we have to take 4 centimeters radius. So here, take radius from the scale. This is your starting point and this is your end point. From this point to this point here, 4 centimeters radius. So take 4 centimeters radius. With D as center, draw an arc. Next, what we have to do? We have to take B as center. How much radius we have to take? 3.5 centimeters. So at 0 starting point, 3.5 means 3 after 5th line. So the length in between these two points is 3.5 centimeters. Now with this radius, with B as center, you cut this arc. Where these two arcs intersects, at this point, this intersecting point of two arcs, you name it as C. Now we have to join CD and PC. Immediately you write the measurements. Length of CD is 4 centimeters. BC is 3.5 centimeters. If you want, you can measure and see. So this is C, 4 centimeters. This is, you have 3.5 centimeters. So which is your required quadrilateral? This is your main construction. Now, let's recap this process through steps of construction. First, what we have to do? Draw AB line segment 5.5 centimeters. Next, using compass, we have to construct XAB as 45 degrees. Next one, with A as center, radius 5 centimeters, you have to draw an arc which intersects AX ray at D. That is your third point. Next one, with D as center, radius 4 centimeters, we have to draw an arc. Next, with B as center, radius 3.5 centimeters, you have to draw an arc which intersects the previous arc at C. Next, what we done here, we have to join, we joined here BC and CD. Now here required quadrilateral ABCD is constructed. Children, this is the way we have to construct the quadrilateral when four sides and one angle are given. Okay, in next session, we see how to construct a quadrilateral using various possible dimensions. You do the same sum as assignment. Thank you.